Now, do you have Stephen here, yes?
Yeah, you've got two.
What?
I'm Stephen.
You're here with another friend called Stephen?
No, I'm with...
Is that your imaginary friend or somebody else?
It's...
Yes, I know who you are. It's on the papers. I'm just checking. Do we have Stephen here?
Yes.
You're quite sure about that?
Yeah, I'm sure...
Good Lord, yes. Question number one. We may be here for some time. And is it Steve?
It is, yes.
Thank you very much. Steve and Stephen, correct? Now, Steve, that's your friend Stephen over there, correct?
Yes.
I see you smiling. Your friend Stephen's a rather generous man, wouldn't you agree?
Yeah, he is, yeah.
You've known Steve for 25 years.
That's correct.
Now, in general, the way that you describe Steve, I have to tell you, makes things rather complicated for me in terms of your motivation for what you did. So, as I understand it, you're a hotelier, is that correct?
That is correct, yes.
How long have you owned and operated a hotel?
18 years.
You've got a lot of different groups of friends, correct? Your sensible ones and the ones who are a little bit naughty, correct?
Yeah, go on.
What do you mean, yeah, go on?
Yeah. OK. I agree.
You agree?
Yes.
At some point, sir, you wanted to either start a new business or, more importantly, get a new van for your existing business, correct?
Yes.
Why didn't you have the capital or the cash to buy that van yourself?
4 months prior, I had an armed robbery at my house.
Right. Was anything taken in the course of that armed robbery?
No, just tied up.
I'm very sorry to...
No, just pause
for a second, sir. Very sorry to hear that.
It's OK.
It's an armed robbery in your house.
Yeah.
They didn't take anything...
Because
what
was...
happened?
They come for a safe, contents of a safe, which wasn't there. But obviously, because of that experience, that put me into a bit of depression for, say, 2-3 months. So it couldn't work.
How's it affecting you now?
Not too bad.
Now, comes to you and asks you for money. How much did he come and ask to borrow, sir?
2,000.
You did a very sensible thing. And I have to tell you, sir, it may or may not have rescued your case. The reason I'm asking you about your due diligence is because what I have in front of me is a situation where somebody expresses to you that they haven't worked. They haven't worked because they are clearly quite understandably traumatised. Mm-hmm. You lend them the £2,000 at a time where you can't conceivably have clear confidence that they're going to be able to work perhaps ever again.
Yes.
Do you see?
Yes.
Now, he handed over the £2,000, correct? Did you buy a van with that money?
Not initially. I couldn't find the right van.
Well, what did you do with the £2,000?
I kept it.
Right. Did you eventually buy a van with that money? How much did you spend?
Not only £1,000 with the money.
What happened to the other £1,000?
I offered to give Steve another £500 back.
Where's the £1,000?
In the bank.
You look like you're doing...
In the bank.
Did you spend the money on dancing lessons?
I did, yes.
Well, I can see.
No, it's in the bank.
In the bank now?
Yes.
Well, why haven't you given it back?
Because he only wanted £200 a month.
Sir? You were just having a think, had 2 whole minutes or thereabouts to work out whilst you were doing the okie-cokie.
Yeah.
You ready?
I am, yes.
Knees bent, arms stretched, rah, rah, rah. Where's the money? The first 200 didn't arrive the next month.
Yes.
The next 200 didn't arrive.
Yes.
What happened? This is where we get to the £500. What happened?
Well, Steve had promised to sort of pop around and pay the 200 on different occasions, and it simply just didn't happen. So I decided that I would take...
How long after the 27th of March did this happen, please?
I would say probably a couple of months, maybe 10 weeks.
At this stage, you are getting concerned that he hasn't made any repayments, right?
Yes.
You also don't know for sure the value of the van that he's purchased.
Yes.
As I understand it from your application, what you did was go and visit Steve along with a friend as a witness, correct?
Yes, that's correct.
Not an unsensible idea. I have to check just to be clear. You weren't taking a friend along as muscle or anything like that?
Oh, no, he's only a little chap.
How many other £200 did you receive after that?
Nothing.
None. Now, do you have reason to believe that Steve is going to be able to pay back the rest of the £1,500 he still owes on the agreement?
is capable of it. Whether or not it's going to happen, I'm not too sure.
I attempted to give him some money, and like I say, in his blasé attitude.
Not blasé.
Be quiet.
What? Not blasé.
He says,
sir, please, just know when you're winning.
Sorry, okay.
I'm okay for now.
Do you remember this?
There's been lots of phone calls.
Has there been phone calls where he said, I'd like to give you money, I'd like to give you money?
Yes, lots of them.
Right.
I'm going to drop some money around for you. I'll pop around and give you some money. Different versions of the same thing.
Right. So these are not you saying, don't worry. These are promises that are made to you where he's going to drop money.
I would also say, like, oh, okay, fine, I'll see you in a bit. You never turned up.
Thank you very much. Correct? Correct.
Correct.
In respect of this case, I have no difficulty whatsoever but coming to the conclusion that Steve has no intention, capacity or interest in paying back this money, has made a series of unfulfilled promises, and consequently, the rest of the loan is now delinquent and there is no reasonable prospect of him paying it back. Therefore, you are entitled to a judgment, which this court awards you of £1,500. That's the award of this court. Don't be stupid. Stay and watch the best Judge Rinder moments. And I'm talking. Understood? Don't be a moron. Subscribe to Judge Rinder YouTube channel. Right now. That's an order.